Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Northern Lion Live Super Show, January 8th, Wednesday, 2014 edition. I'm not bothering to put those in the proper order. You can figure it out for your goddamn self. I, as always, am your host, Northern Lion, joined by my esteemed co-host, Rockley Smile.
Hey, everybody.
As well as Jay Smith OTI, and I purposely introduced you last because apparently you have some news for us.
I have nudes for you. Well, it's not really nudes, but no. So I have news.
Okay.
So you know how Moobot has like your custom sound bites that you can put on there?
Yes.
For like new subs.
No,
I changed mine.
Because it doesn't for me.
Well, Nick's is broke. but I changed mine. You remember that horrible noise that I had when I spit out my water?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's it now. So like it's also the end of like Dracula Fetus's video. So it's like do
bleh. Gurgle splash.
And, wow.
Yes, yeah, splash. That's what it's. So if you want to hear that, you know, you could spend $5. I think that's probably a worthy price. Plus all the emoticons that I have in my chat. Raise your OTI pixels and OTI washers, of course.
OTI washers.
It's actually just OTI wash, but you can raise the washing machines as well. It's really good. It's really, yeah, it's like the burp, the infamous burp.
It just works for you?
Hmm?
What?
Mm-hmm.
It just works for
yeah,
you?
Yeah, you just...
Doesn't work
yeah,
for me.
Yeah, I made a little sound bite. I used Fraps to record just like XSplit, like randomly, yeah. And then I trimmed out all the video and made it a .wave file and I uploaded it.
So I'd just like to point out that the... First, you took a friend of the channel, Brack the Man's likeness... And then just basically sold it without his permission. Well, he didn't even own it, but let's ignore that. Let's ignore that!
Yeah, I had to actually...
And then Dracula Fetus, out of the goodness of his heart, creates these animations, and you're just like, oh yeah, I'm going to sell that too.
Well, yeah.
This is the point you've gotten.
Try it out.
I'm not going to try it out. I do have some water with me, but I'm going to drink it like a responsible adult. In any case...
I might try it out.
Nick's going to try it out. Along with Tomato Mod. Today's docket, it's a good one. We're going to be playing some Family Feud 2010 edition because I don't know how to stay away from this goddamn game. Then we're going to be transitioning to some Cook Serve Delicious because I don't know how to stay away from that goddamn game. During our trivia section, we're giving away copies of Loom, the point-and-click adventure game with papercraft visuals that is goddamn gorgeous. Also, I just noticed today it has a 69 on Metacritic.
Nice.
You can't make this stuff up. .png.
Really can.
.tiff. Finally... Instead of playing Spelunky, we're going to be playing a little bit of Seated Isaac Runs at the end just to keep it separated and mostly because I died in like 3 minutes on yesterday's Daily Challenge. Shall we get started with the Family Feud?
Yeah.
I'm going to be drawing Nicolas Cage today, so if you guys want to come over and watch.
Nick, that's a banger right there.
I'm a banger.
The original Hulk, the TV show Hulk.
Lou Ferrigno.
Lou Ferrigno, that's
yeah.
it. Guy Fieri.
It's not Guy Fieri. I will stand for the Steve Harwell Guy Fieri comparisons because I'm pretty sure that they're just like
draw the line.
Whoa.
Someone did it. 212-201-35-08723. Up down all around. Welcome you to J Smithtown. Thank you very much.
Also, Pets 485. Up down to the side, welcome to the Lion Pride. Okay, Family Feud 2010 edition.
Toxic
name someone
rain, up down all around. Welcome to James Smithtown as well.
Name someone for whom you feel forced to buy a Christmas gift. I'm gonna say it's. There's many possible answers here. I'm gonna say mom.
Name a relative.
Yeah.
Lion's Law.
Okay, so parents are number three. Oh Lord, steampunk nudist. What a great name. So is that like your dick's hanging out, but you have like a top hat on and some gears on it?
Either you got a gear on your dong, basically.
Oh my God, the dong gears. In-laws is ahead of parents?
Girlfriend.
Well, I figured that, like, spouse or, like, you know, relationship
second
partner
spouse.
Would be... Yeah, second spouse.
If you can
second
get away
maid.
With that kind of thing. Whoa.
I figured that would be up there somewhere, but I figured universally more people have parents than spouses, probably. I guess it depends how old they are.
Sometimes parents just don't understand, though.
That's what I've heard as well.
Also, boss was number two. Name someone you feel you have to buy a Christmas gift for, your boss. That's some fucking narcissistic asshole running the company, if you ask me. He should be the one giving you the gift.
That does happen. Like, you get, like, really friendly with, like, your coworkers. I hate it.
Dude, I have never purchased a Christmas gift for a coworker. The asterisk there is obligatory Secret Santa shit that I don't want to take part in the first place, but I have to because it's for morale. What about my morale, Kathy? Anyway. Josh.
Kathy.
Mm-hmm. Kathy's just the... when you become an HR personnel, you become Kathy.
I know.
Josh, tell me one fact about John Lennon. By the way, we got swept there.
He's Beatles.
Beatles. Same. Good answer.
That's the one. That is the only one. No,
Beatles.
Only one.
Member of Beatles number one. Six more things. You think we're up to this?
No.
All right. Nick, tell me something about John Lennon.
He was assassinated.
Yeah. Assassinated. Is it up there? That's number two. Shot slash murdered.
Shots fired.
Tell me one fact.
Too soon?
Tell me one fact about John Lennon. He's British. What? Oh, it's not up there. I don't buy this game. I'm losing my feud foo, if you will.
Is he not British? He is British.
He's maybe it's English. Whoa, two subscriptions, Banana Brand Muffin and Gozita 2003. Josh, tell me one fact about John Lennon up to Enter the Side, Welcome to the Lion Pride.
Took drugs.
Drugs. That's an X. This is the Family Feud, not the... It's double X, not triple X. You know what I mean?
Also,
okay.
Nick.
Is this implied by Beatles that he's a musician?
I'll type musician.
I feel like it's worth doing. It might be too obvious, though.
Musician was number three, singer slash musician.
Okay, cool.
Kerr PMA. Thank you very much for the subscription. Apparently, John Lennon was actually Irish.
My bad. Someone said Welsh in mine, so I don't trust anybody.
Well,
right. Sorry, guys.
He was from the United Kingdom. He's United Kingdom-ish. I'm just going to type Yoko Ono, and like that'll be on there.
That
somewhere.
Will. Yeah.
Number four, married Yoko Ono. Sure. Three more, under eight. Answer,
did they play at Woodstock?
No.
No.
Famous?
Yeah, it could be, man.
Yeah, I mean, I'll buy that.
Famous. Famous is our third X. Pride 45. Up down to
has
the
hair.
Side. You are the 45th Pride. What's your answer? With Tomo, what's wrong, buddy?
Tomo Arigato.
Yeah, we got a new kitten. We called it Tomo. There's so many great names. You come up with
why
Tomo? Well, Mech6 Ryan just subscribed as well. We'll talk about that later. He sent me an alpha build for a game called Frog. It's Frog Super Meat Boy meets Ninja Gaiden. Frog Sword without a W in it. He wore glasses and believed
name.
In peace. Those were the two that we missed. He wore glasses, believed in peace. But anyway, we got this kitten called Tomo. Who doesn't believe in peace? Anyway. One second. I'm getting scatterbrained here. Nick, name something a teenager will not leave the house without.
Phone?
Yeah, I think it's a good answer. Although I think all these are taken from like the 80s, so they would actually need to take
yeah,
out their whole house with them.
Gadavrek, shout out to you. Thank you for the subscription. Welcome to the Rock Quarry.
Cell phones is number one. Very good. I'm going to say... now, after cell phone, it just becomes like name things you don't want to leave
teenagers,
the house without, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm thinking like keys. You don't want to leave the house without your keys. There you go. That's number four. What do you got?
Teenage friends have keys?
Friends.
What about friends?
Friends.
Tomo?
Tomo? Can you hear that?
Yeah, he's adorable.
He's really tiny. Tominator? What's wrong, buddy?
Dominator.
That's my favorite of all of the pet names.
I didn't think of that one.
Nick, name something a teenager will not leave the house without.
I hear the meowing.
Wallet? Did you say wallet yet?
Wallet. I think that's a good one. Oh, it's not on there.
Damn.
Tomo. I'm going to say money. I'm going to cut the middleman out.
So cute.
Not all teenagers have wallets. That's for fucking
corporate
stooges,
right.
Man. I just carry my money in my pocket.
Or a clip.
All right, Josh. If you're a teenager with a money clip.
No, I knew teenagers with money clips.
Okay. I have a money clip on my wallet.
Do you have an answer?
On your wallet?
Purse?
Excuse me?
Purse.
Purse was the triple X. Oh, no.
Too many strikes. Diesel? I don't know.
They're
car. What else? A car makes a lot of sense, actually. I always assumed, like, things that they would need from the door to the car. And possibly from the window to the walls. iPod? We just lost.
Oh, are we going that modern?
I have Zoom.
Are we going that modern? And then it pops up iPod / Walkman. So, not necessarily that makeup, number six. You know what would be really good if you had all these things? a purse so you could put them in.
No.
By the way, we just lost in record time. That is, like, we're 13 minutes in, and we just got steamrolled. In three rounds, I think, or four rounds. No, that was only three rounds. I didn't even think that was possible.
They're taking rounds away from us now.
Well, we never got any points. Because we suck.
We're not that bad. We've won a few times.
We probably have like a 20% win rate, and then it's a coin flip on fast money.
Okay, you're right about
that. We have a 69% lose rate.
Well, whenever we lose 69% of the time, everybody wins all the time.
Right.
Okay. Name a place where people hope to go someday. is heaven like...
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
That's what I was thinking.
I'm going to say heaven, but I also think Disney World might be number one.
Yeah.
They might be the same thing. We're not sure. Science hasn't confirmed it yet.
I'm going to go with heaven. Heaven is number one. Okay, good.
Good job.
All right. Well, Josh, name a place where people want to go someday.
Disney World.
Disney World, I think, is a good answer. Disney World, Disneyland. You said it. Disneyland / World, number two. The Incoherent Gamer, up down to the side, welcome to the Lion Pride. Nick, name a place where people hope to go someday.
I'm thinking vacationing out to Europe or something. How about that?
Yeah, Europe. That's an X.
Damn.
Devoid of cultural, culinary, and artistic value.
College.
Oh, dude, thanks for staying that out loud.
You changed the whole game.
Oh, college is an X. Okay, you have... You want to go to college?
That was a great answer for a short amount of time.
Yeah.
All right, Josh, name a place where people hope to go someday.
The Caribbean?
You want?
Oh, the beach? I don't know. Beach.
The beach. The beach.
The beach.
The beach.
The ocean. Beach.
Beach was a third strike.
Beach. That's second beach.
You're letting your Australia bias cloud you. Also, a subscription. Well warranted from Josh Plock's Take Off the Shirt.
I'm going to put another shirt on this. You
have to do it. Oh, bullshit. Dude, Hawaii was on there.
Oh, that's like a beach and an island.
Yeah. You might get nabbed by Dog the Bounty Hunter if you go out there.
Is he in? Oh, Paris.
Is
so
he still in operation?
I don't know what he's doing, man.
Okay, name a place you'd like to go somewhere. Let's go over these answers. Heaven. Okay. Disneyland / World, Hawaii, Florida, Paris. That's so specific. Also, Awesome Rash, thank you very much for the subscription.
Awesome Rash.
Of course, we will still do shout outs at the end. This one's for you, Josh. Name something that can do a lot of damage to a home.
A chainsaw. No, termites.
All right.
Chainsaw.
Termites is number three. Pretty good. Really chainsaw. I don't get why Florida's on there. Florida, it's hot, but don't you want to just like...
You vacation there.
Do you, though?
Well, you go to Disney World there.
Canadians vacation in Florida. Yeah, Chat's got a good point. Disneyland or World is in Florida.
It's World. Land is California.
Okay. We actually managed to get this one on the value of your answer there, Josh. So we've got termites. Name something that can do a lot of damage to a home, Nick.
I would like to say tornado.
I think that's a great answer.
Or chainsaw, either one.
Tornado.
I think chainsaw is not a bad answer.
I mean, you're right. It would cause a lot of damage.
Water / nature. Well, that really takes out the hurricane answer I was going to go
shit.
With.
Shit.
I'm gonna say earthquake, even though that probably comes under nature somehow. Earthquake's an X. All right. Sorry, San Francisco, 1906. Anyway.
Sixth sense, second nature.
Josh, name something that can do a lot of damage to a home.
Burglars.
Really? Like, real assholes.
Well, they throw shit around.
Okay, burglars are number five. They take your shit
and
then they just, like, put termites in the walls.
How's your tornadoes coming along?
I would rather have burglars than a fucking earthquake, maybe. Nick, name something that can do a lot of damage to a home.
I'm thinking maybe this is a little crazy, but I'm thinking like a car if it smashes into your house.
Sure, man. Car.
What about a Hulk?
That's happened a bunch of times. Like crazy people, drunk people, is crash into houses.
It's not on there. I get where you're going with it. I think I'm gonna say kids, but I actually cheated and looked at chat.
Like the MGMT song.
Yeah.
Like Vagrant
I looked at chat and I went fire is just like the most obvious answer.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Fire, number two.
That's really good.
Alright. What's your answer? Josh, name something that can do a lot of damage to a home.
Burst pipes?
Burst pipes. I think that would be underwater.
Maybe that's like cold? I don't know.
Underwater, I'm pretty sure.
No, I don't know.
Wait,
mold.
Nature, I thought, is why we didn't do a lot of those.
Mold. Well, it's water slash nature. It's not
there. Oh. And this
is burst choice. Pipes are bad because of the water, right? It's not because the pipes are burst. I think. I don't know, man.
It's because the water freezes and expands.
There's nobody's like, oh, there's too much ice in my house. I guess
Eskimos.
Unless
maybe.
If your pipes burst, then yeah, you would say that.
Your pipes don't burst and then like just ice cubes pour out onto your floor.
That would be sweet, though.
That would be pretty sweet. Okay.
They think it'd be sweet.
Number six was pets slash animals. Okay, that makes sense.
I believe it.
Number four was arguments and fights. Ooh.
Ooh.
Whoa.
Awkward.
Yeah. Different kind of broken home. All right, Nick, based on their personality, what kind of bird would you compare your mate to? This is a pretty obvious answer, I would say.
Okay. Let's say a flamingo.
Wow. All right, this guy lives on the wild side. Flamingo's not on there.
Long legs, hot pink.
Yeah. So, they're probably going to get this and then play it. I think we should brainstorm some steals.
I don't honestly understand this question, really.
It's kind of like
kind
name
of bird?
A name a bird. I think...
I did, it didn't work.
Oh, they passed. Okay, we can do this.
I don't like
parrot.
They passed. You
Mocking
wait for
Jay.
Your answer. I am going to say, based on the personality, what kind of bird would you compare your mate to? They're like a peacock. They're very confident.
A dude?
Peacock's not on there?
Yeah, peacock's a dude.
Oh, peahen. I'm not going to put peahen. The bird is called a peacock. All right, Josh.
No, the man is called a peacock.
Oh, okay.
Josh. What did I say? Parrot.
She just repeats everything you say?
Yeah.
Wow, parrot's number one. What is it with you and these, like, if humans were animals, what would they look like? Shit, you know it so well.
I'm a man of many wisdoms.
Nick, what kind of bird would you compare your mate to?
I want to do this, but I guess, like, since you don't care about the sex of the bird, I'm going to say, like, a rooster.
All right. Is your answer there? Rooster's not on there.
Of course it isn't.
Chicken.
Chicken might be, yeah.
Oh, come on. If it's rooster, it's chicken.
See, that's what I say.
No, it's chicken.
Am I crazy to say, like, dove? Okay. Shit, okay. Family Feud law, name a bird. I'm going to say it's a hawk.
Whoa, aggressive Ooh. Predator type.
Probably should have gone with swan.
Oh, yeah.
Now that I think about it.
What an angry goose.
What is it? So it's a flamingo, angry goose.
Chicken.
What did you marry? Like a zoo?
I don't know.
Did you marry Jack
Hanna? I don't like
Hanna?
This question. I'm not marrying Jack
Hanna.
It's wacky.
We won that category.
That's garbage.
Because this guy compared his wife to a vulture. Are you prepare for the real Family Feud when he gets home.
The real Family Feud starts here.
Crow slash raven. Not sure if that's a good thing.
Crow slash secondary.
That's so raven.
Dodo, because it doesn't exist, I guess.
Dodo?
Anymore. Hummingbird. Is it like vaguely sexual? Blue jay. Wouldn't have expected that. All right.
Mockingjay.
That was not...
What about an owl? Because your head turns all the way around.
Well,
a circle.
Owl wasn't on there. That's the beauty of having all the answers now.
I like that.
Name
Is that
something that's considered rude to cancel at the last minute.
A date?
It's like a wedding.
Yeah, a wedding is totally where I'd go with that.
But is it too extreme for most people to think about it? Wedding was number two. Party slash wedding. There's a big difference between those two.
Very, very big.
You could cancel your fucking, like, Christmas party. Canceling a wedding is a big deal.
There's implications.
Fucking Josh, with date was number one.
Told you.
How do you do this?
I'm a man of many mysteries and knowledges.
Well, they passed it to us anyway, so we only need to get three more. So, Josh, name something that's considered rude to cancel at the last minute.
An interview.
Okay.
That's a good one. Good answer.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Don't tell him it's a good answer. It's not a good answer.
Oh, I thought it was, though.
Nick, name something that's considered rude to cancel at the last minute.
Funeral, but that's pretty weird. Appointment. Can we just say appointment in general?
Appointment is good. There you go. Doctor's appointment number 3.
Okay.
I'm just going to say meeting. I'm going to keep it nondescript.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Meeting was an X. All right. No. There you go again, Nick, giving me positive reinforcement for bad answers.
I just want you to feel good.
I do feel good. Okay,
cancel.
Josh.
Something that you cancel?
Yeah.
You cancel a dinner reservation. No, that's already a date. You cancel a... fuck, dude. I don't know.
I know, right?
I managed to type in reservation at the last second, and that was number 4.
Oh, oh, God damn it.
Wow, okay. Nick, name something that's rude to cancel at the last minute.
He said interview already. A class? Like a school class? Like at college?
I guess that would be rude. I'll type it in there.
It's happened to me. It was rude.
Oh, class is an X. Oh. But if they get it wrong, we will actually win. And they've got to get the, they've got to get this answer. So whoever gets this right, or if they get it right, they win. If they get it wrong, they... I said class, Brian!
What did he say?
He said class.
No.
So we
took my answer and won with it?
No, they didn't win.
Oh, they just lost.
Brian has no class.
Excuse me?
Brian has no class?
So, remember when we typed appointment and doctor's appointment came up?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Number 5 was hair appointment.
Yeah, they're totally different types of appointment.
It should have popped up both of them together. Okay, why don't we have Josh go away and Nickel starts.
Okay.
Brian is going to get slapped in the face when he goes home. Called his wife a vulture, said the same wrong answer. Name a location where you had your first kiss.
People say car a lot, I think.
Oh, that's going to be a good one. Family Feud, and it's right. Name something on your plane you hope is working.
Well, given the whole conversation we had yesterday, the reclining part of the chair?
I'm not going with that.
Okay.
I hope it isn't working.
The speaker, the headphone jack.
What the heck, man? You're more worried about your entertainment than staying up in the sky?
Oh, I thought we were just talking, given that that was right. Did you enter this already?
No, it's still going.
The engine, then. The engine.
Yeah, okay. There.
I misunderstood.
All right.
I'm scum.
Name something you would. Name something you wouldn't want to have two of.
Oh, I can't say dongs now.
You could.
Two wives.
Yeah.
There you go.
Am I right? Name something a man needs to really enjoy a football game.
A beer.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. From his one wife. Name something you'd hate to see your dentist holding.
Chainsaw.
Yeah, that's. I'll type that. It seems pretty.
Is that really, that's not gonna be on there though.
It could be.
All right, fine.
We'll go with it. I think there's some good answers in here. Car was 20 with the top results for first kiss.
Ooh, that's a bad poll then.
Yeah, it is a bad poll. Engine top answer was 54.
Glad I didn't use headphone jack. Thank you for talking
I'm
me out of that.
Pretty sure headphone jack's gonna have like 2. Wives also the top answer with 31.
Yes.
I'm pretty sure beer's going to be the top answer. Yep, beer with 56.
Oh, it's got to be beer, of course.
Yeah, so you're at 161 already. And chainsaw, 0.
All right, I was... Yeah, I didn't think it was going to work.
So, hey, Josh!
Hello.
Josh, Nick got 161.
What, you couldn't get 8 more?
Yeah, that's what I thought, too.
Josh, name a location where you had your first kiss.
Movies.
Good answer.
Yeah, good answer.
Name something on your plane you hope is working.
The pilot?
Well, obviously he's working if he's in the plane. Name something you wouldn't want to have two of.
Butts.
I'll type it. Two butts.
No hesitation at all.
Name something a man really needs to enjoy a football game.
A beer. Friends.
Yeah, I think that's a good answer.
That is good, yeah.
Name something you'd hate to see your dentist holding.
The chainsaw. A drill?
I think drill's a fine answer.
It should have been like your lower jaw.
Yeah, that'd be real bad. Okay, pilot got 8, so you did hit 169. Movie theater got 0, which is weird. Butts got 0. Friends got 5. You need 26 on drill. And you got 62, so that'll do.
Pineapple pubes! Up, down, all around, welcome to J. Smith Town. And thank you for making my throw-up noise happen again.
Hey, we won fast money. Basically because Josh got all of his points on the final answer.
Movie theater got 0. How does that happen?
Yeah, that's crazy, right? Like, I don't even know. Nick said car. Car was number 1 with 20 points. What else even is there for first kiss? School, maybe?
Or just like bedroom dance or something.
Yeah, bedroom, dance. Those are probably pretty good. Thing a man needs to enjoy a football game. Number 2 answer, big screen TV. I'm thinking.
Yeah.
Beer had like 99 of the answers, though. Fair enough, really.
Yeah.
You know what the number 1 thing I need to enjoy a football game is? A remote.
I don't get it.
Change it to TV. Something better. All right. Name a type of repairman whom you suspect is out to cheat you. Okay. Which repairman has the worst reputation? Auto mechanic.
That's what I was going to say.
It's true. Well, I don't know. I don't own a car, but people tell me it's true. Mechanic is number 2. What do you think could be number 1 here? Plumber?
Mm-hmm. Are they cheaty?
Electrician? Electrician was number 4. We're going to play this one. Die Teach in chat said, my first kiss was in Savannah, Georgia, so he's pretty sure that's the number 1 answer.
Mm.
Yeah, there's a lot of kissing going on in Georgia.
It's Florida. That's why everyone wants to go there. I mean, well, Savannah, Georgia is not in Florida, obviously. Anyway.
It's close.
It is close. Josh, name a type of repairman who you suspect is out to cheat you.
Plumber.
Yeah, it's a good answer, even though every plumber I've ever talked to seemed like a very personable person.
Same.
Personable person. Well, that's fucking good.
Nick, name a type of repairman whom you suspect is out to cheat you.
I'm going to say, like, carpenter.
Yeah, sure.
It's another thing that I can say.
It's not on there?
Oh.
I like how of all the mistakes in this game, they still take the effort to say whom properly. Like that strikes me as weirdly attentive to detail. Name a type of repairman whom you suspect is out to cheat you. TV repairman. Fuck, dude.
What about like computer repairman?
All right, well, yeah. TV repairman was number 7. Much to my surprise. What do you have, Josh?
Computer repairman?
Computer, like Geek Squad.
Yeah, they're the worst.
They installed my parents' Xbox 360 for $75.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's a tough hour's work.
Yep. Didn't even set up the gamer profile. Nick, name a type of repairman whom you suspect is out to cheat you.
Have we said cable guy yet?
I can go with cable guy? Hey, cable guy is number 5. It said cableman, though. I like that better. Cableman. Name a type of repairman who you suspect is out to cheat you. What about just like a renovator or construction or...
That's kind of where I was going with the carpenter, but...
Yeah, builder?
I feel like there could be more ground there.
Builder?
Bob?
Hey, builder's number 5. Builder slash contractor. Number 6, sorry. All right, we've only got one more left, Josh.
Is there like an appliance repairman?
Appliance?
Like coming over and fix your refrigerator. Is your refrigerator running? No, motherfucker. Doesn't have legs.
Yeah, that'd be weird.
Appliance repairman.
I said appliance repairman. It wasn't on there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to be real mad if it is like refrigerator repairman. And I think it could be because I was thinking about that. What else could it be? Air conditioning, says chat. Roofer?
Fix your washer.
Oh, roofer.
Oh, yeah, HVAC. HVAC.
Apparently it's roofer, so sorry.
Really?
Yep, we lost.
Roofer.
This is the thing about playing this AI, is you have to get everything right in the category or you just lose. And if you pass, then all of the fucking, they'll just sweep you. Okay. All right, here's one for you, Josh. Name a reason someone might say they love living in Las Vegas.
The hangover.
Hookers. Gambling.
I'm not going to say hookers.
Gambling.
Gambling. Gambling slash casino, number one. So you got, they're a gambling addict, they're an alcoholic.
Yeah, like, what the fuck?
Nick, name a reason, like, someone might say they love living in Las Vegas. Gambling was number one.
The fast living? Is that a way to,
fast,
is that a thing?
Fast
what
life.
Is, what is that
beautiful
say about
women?
The people of Las Vegas?
Oh, okay, women.
What about, like, the temperature, the climate?
It's real hot.
The
real
job. Hot the
very
job.
The job hot. Market in Las Vegas is real good.
Yeah.
Outstanding.
Women was not on there. Mm. I almost want to put, like, you can smoke indoors.
That's an attraction across the
nation. I think it seriously might be. Smoke indoors was an X.
Now you've got two
strikes. Okay. Or the other family can speak. All right, Josh.
Climate. Answer, please.
Climate. I'll type climate. They're crazy, by the way. Nice
people
weather.
Like it. Yeah.
It was like 111 Fahrenheit when I went there. It's insane.
Was it? Yeah, but wasn't it dry?
Yeah, it was dry as hell. They had to have misters so people didn't, like, crack and break into dust on the street. Nick, name a reason someone might say they love living in Las Vegas.
There aren't any more. Those are all of them.
I'm just going to type nightlife.
Okay.
It's an X, but at least we put something.
There aren't any more.
It's like attractions, shows.
Oh, yeah, Penn and Teller are there. I guess that's one.
I saw Penn and Teller when I went to Las Vegas, actually.
Nice.
They were entertaining.
Penn and tell me about it. Never, because I don't want to hear your life story.
Lots of money. Oh, okay. I don't get the context, though. It's on there. But do you you win lots of money, or you have lots of money?
They have lots of money that you can't have.
Oh, yeah, exactly. So entertainment was number three. Bright lights, number five. Cost of living was number six.
Is it really cheap there?
I mean, not if you do the number one answer, which was gambling.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like it'd be an inexpensive city.
Nick, name a place you go so often, the people who work there know your name. The liquor store.
Oh, the Cheers bar.
Cheers. Yeah, the bar.
You think bar might really be number one?
Yeah, I really think bar.
Yeah, because everybody knows your name.
Yeah.
That says something. Okay, bar was number four.
I don't go to bars, really. This is just the thing I know about
the doctor's
culture.
Office, the dentist's office.
I don't think the dentist knows.
No, but the dentist knows my name.
The local GameStop.
Church was number two, by the way, but they decided to pass it.
Work. Go to work. Work.
I agree. I think work is they should know your name, at least. Oh, work is an X. Never mind.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
They don't know your name at work?
All right, Josh.
Jesus.
I like this. This guy said bright lights. Is that a selling point for living in Las Vegas? Did they interview insects? Anyway.
Doctor's office.
Why are you at the doctor's office so often? Probably because you're going to the bar every night.
Yeah.
Doctor's number six.
All right.
I can't tell if Nicolas Cage's blue eyes are green.
His eyes are...
I didn't even give the whole guy.
His eyes are ever-changing stars going into supernova and being reborn.
That's cool. Voids.
Nick, name the place you go so often the people who work there know your name.
School?
I think school is an absolutely adequate answer that they provided an X for.
Okay.
What the fuck is number one?
Dentist's office?
I don't think the dentist is number one. I almost want to say
the
like...
The grocery store?
Maybe. I'm thinking like cafe? Really? Like coffee shop?
Oh, yeah, because the Starbucks, they know what coffee order you make every day.
Ah, that's true. Okay, restaurant was number three. I think that still means coffee shop could be open there. Josh, do you have an
coffee
answer?
Coffee shop.
You want to go coffee
Josh
shop?
Yeah, that's... in that answer.
Yeah. But I like the dentist's office, too.
Oh, it's up to you. Which one would you like
dentist.
To okay. Dentist.
Conversist.
Dentist is the third X.
God damn it.
I'm not surprised.
Well, I didn't want to steal Nick's answer.
You shouldn't be going to the dentist that often.
No, you could steal whatever you want from me, man. It's fine.
Nick, I'm going to just like break into your house and steal your computer tomorrow.
No, we got the bro code, man. It's fine.
The bank. The bank was number 5.
No.
Dude, who's going to the bank every day?
Oh, number 1 was just store.
Oh. We're way too specific.
So, I guess we should have just said outside. Ugh. Yeah. All right. Well, we can still win. They didn't win, so we can get triple here. What is your favorite casino in Las Vegas to lose all your money at? What is this? This episode is sponsored by the Tourism Bureau of Las Vegas.
The strip club.
The favorite casino. Dude. What's the biggest casino in Vegas, man? Caesar's Palace.
Caesar Milan's Palace.
MGM.
Caesar's Palace, number 1. Boom.
Shakalaka.
Name casinos in Las Vegas.
Las Vegas casinos. Thanks for taking me there when I was 2 days over 21, Mom and Dad. Time to pay for itself. Josh, favorite casino in Las Vegas?
MGM?
The MGM Grande.
I've never been to Las Vegas, so I hope you guys can help me with answers for this.
Absolutely. MGM Grand was number 3. Do you have one, Nick?
I don't actually really. I think I would have said Caesar's Palace as well. That's all I know.
Could be like the Luxor.
Oh, yeah, I know the Luxor. Okay.
It's the big pyramid.
Yeah. I didn't realize I knew that.
Luxor, number 2. All right. All right, huh? Okay. You got Bally's.
Did you give me your last answer? I'm sorry.
Yes.
Is that the Bellagio?
Oh, dude, Bellagio, totally. Bellagio. Let's
hope it's there. Has Trump built anything yet?
Bellagio's not on there.
Bellagio.
Neither.
That was in the Lucky Ocean's 11.
You're telling me, man? Okay, Nick, it's all up to you. What's your favorite casino in Las Vegas?
I don't say that. I'm going to just look at your chat and see if there's anything good in here.
New York.
Stratosphere, New York.
New York.
Rio.
I stated the Rio.
Gamora? Why didn't you tell us that? That would have been
the Mirage. Mahal. Mirage, Rio. Number 4.
Okay.
Rio.
Okay, we got Rio, Gold Nugget. You want me to type the Rio?
Yeah, I want you to type Rio.
It's a shithole.
So am I, so I'm still on this show.
Well, Rio's it's true. Rio's the third X.
God damn it.
That was pretty good. We got 4 of them. Wonder what it's going to be. It could be Treasure Island. I saw Cirque du Soleil there. Oh, it was Harrah's.
Who?
Harrah's. Harrah's.
Isn't that like Zeus's wife or something?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
It is, man. Well,
what's she doing there?
Zeus's wife.
We basically suck.
Card games.
We try. Sure, yes. Hey, this is a good time to point out if you've been enjoying the stream. Make sure to click the follow button to be notified of when we go live in the future. You can also subscribe if you are interested. If you subscribe to me, it plays a mushroom sound. If you subscribe to Josh, it's him throwing up in his own mouth. If you subscribe to Nick, Nick's Moobot doesn't work, but it's much appreciated nonetheless.
That's exactly right.
God damn it.
My Nicolas Cage is almost done, by the way.
I can't wait to see this.
This is my worst paint, I'm pretty sure.
Your worst pain or your worst paint?
Paint.
Okay.
Paint.
All right.
It's pretty bad.
Name something a person pays someone else to get rid of. What?
The body.
Bugs.
The trash. Insects.
Whoa. Una Hezadek. Up down to the side. Welcome to the Lion Pride. Name something a person pays someone else to get rid of. Yeah, okay. I'll go with bugs. Was that a good answer? Yes. Number 2. Like, am I crazy to think that money is just the number one answer?
Yeah.
You pay someone to get rid of your money?
Yeah, I think that's a stupid answer.
Okay.
I don't like that answer.
Trash and garbage was number 1. Jason,
pay to get rid
of... It's technically
true. Your virginity. I mean, Craigslist.
Yeah, that makes sense. We have no chance in this category, by the way. Old appliances was number 6. That's how I knew we had no chance.
Yeah, that's a tough one.
Why would you, like, pay someone to get rid of your old appliances? Just pay an extremely trustworthy appliance repairman to show up. They
can't
are
trust
not
any of them. Though.
Yeah, they're not in the top eight least trustworthy professions. Person slash body was number three. Because everybody in the Western world lives in fucking NCIS.
Mafia world.
And NSCSI. You have two strikes so far. What's that show? It is NCIS.
NCIS, yeah.
NCSI. NCIS.
And it's New York CSI.
NCSI.
NCSI.
CSINY. Gotcha.
NYNCI.
LANYCSI.
Miami.
Feels
Miami.
Like Miami. NY Summertime Shy. Yeah, I gotcha.
That's Butterfly. LFO.
That's
Sugar.
Not LFO.
Baby.
Is your answer debt. There? Nate, how can you pay someone to get rid of your... Oh, okay, that makes... That's what I was getting at with money.
That's no. what you said.
I know.
I love that sounded, you didn't understand that one.
It sounded like I was
Steampunk
like,
nudist, welcome. Up, down, all around, welcome to J. Smith Town. I'm so happy I get to hear myself vomiting water every time.
Josh?
Everyone, like, the chat's like, it works. And, like, here it comes. They get so excited.
Josh, name something angry wives throw at their husbands.
Glass.
Just like...
Cups.
Like a box
I don't know.
Glass.
Glasses, cups, dishes, dishes.
Dishes is a good one. We work through it together, and there it is in the number one answer.
Don't throw, guys. Don't throw.
Seriously,
matches.
Like
Dota
really,
matches.
Don't throw things at your spouse, regardless.
They throw their spouses Dota matches.
Nick, name something angry wives throw at their husbands.
The pan. They always have a pan, right? Because sexism?
That's a good point. Yeah, pots, pans, number three.
Yeah, yep.
They throw, like, the phone?
Oh, because they're always on the phone again because sexism.
Yeah. Phone is not on there.
No.
I never understood this. Like, I'm sure it happens, but this is what happens in, like, every relationship in TV shows. Some dude is, like, cowering behind a door while his wife throws, like, breakable shit at him.
Yeah.
Josh, right. Do you have an answer?
Do you have an answer?
I don't know, like...
A pet. Cutlery. I don't know. The dog. Throw the dog at him.
I say cutlery.
Throw dogs.
Don't throw the dog. So
far, dog can't help you.
I thought maybe, like, forks, maybe? Knives would be a little...
Knives, yeah.
What do you have for me, Nick?
Cutlery?
I did cutlery. It wasn't on there. Nick.
How about clothes? Because they're going to have sexy time.
Ah, that's the best part of breaking up is Folgers in your cup.
Yeah, exactly.
Shoes slash clothes, number three. Number four, sorry.
Probably not for the reason I said.
Isn't it? It's always like if you did a TV show, like the girl throws like the vase at the door and then it shatters.
Yep, yep.
Okay.
I'm with you on that.
Vase. Number six.
I wish that wasn't a thing.
Walls.
Yeah. All right, Josh, wow me.
Dr. Dave, they throw subs. Up, down, all around, welcome Mr. Dave Kenny, 10, J. Spithdown. They throw their glasses.
Like, off of their face?
Oh, that's so dangerous. And those are expensive.
Why would you? They wouldn't even do anything.
Dude,
I just broke my $500 frames.
I'm so mad I'm going to break my own glasses.
Stuffed animal?
They throw their wedding ring back at you because they don't want to be married to you anymore.
Oh, dude, pillow totally would have been on there. Insults? Oh, this game's too cerebral for me.
Me too.
Insults slash words. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words. Food slash drinks was five, by the way. Oh, we suck. Hey, PSA, if you're mad at your spouse, male or female, don't throw things at them.
Yeah, really.
Like, especially plates, and, like, that could really
like,
do some
take
damage.
Take a deep breath and get some counseling. It's
Agreed.
Much better.
Yeah. Here we go. This should be great. What television family should make, or would make the best neighbors, Nick?
What television family would make the best neighbors? How about the Simpsons?
Yeah, they'd be really good neighbors.
No, they're always borrowing your shit and then, like...
they'd be really funny, though, even though they'd be awful.
The Simpsons wasn't on there. I'm going to go on record as saying I'm pretty sure number one's going to be the Brady Bunch.
Who did the Cosbys...
They're the Cosbys.
Who were they? Were they the Cosbys?
Who were they?
The Huxtables.
The Huxtables.
All right, they've decided to play. The Cleavers was number one from Leave It to Beaver. What's your
answer? Huxtables.
Huxtables, I think, could be on there.
Say the Huxtables when you get a chance.
Well, I'm not going to get a chance. Oh, the Brady Bunch wasn't on there at all.
Wow.
How is that? Do you have an answer for us? The Kardashians? Chad, you're a bad influence.
The Duck Dynasty people.
Yeah. Landers.
Do they even have a name?
The Huxtables were number two. What do you think?
Mm.
Congratulations, Josh.
Huxtables.
The Taylors?
Really? Oh, the Toolman Taylors from Home Improvement.
Yeah, Jonathan Tim the Toolman Taylor Thomas.
Yeah, he's going to electrocute you and himself in the house around like, you.
His house almost burns down like every episode. The Barones? Okay, so that's everybody loves
Ray Barone. Yeah. Why? Is he could watch like a family hate each other?
Yeah, they like really don't like each other.
The they Tanners, don't like to visit.
Sad.
The Tanners was not on there. That's Full House though, right?
Yes.
What about the Fresh Prince? What's
your answer? That crossed my mind as my first answer, actually.
What are their last names though?
That's what I can't think
Smith.
Of.
Oh shit. We have a chance.
Are they just Smith? The Smiths?
We have a chance. What about the Flintstones?
The Adams.
The Jetsons.
Adams
family.
The Jetsons could be good. I'm kind of going back between like Jetsons and Flintstones.
Mm-hmm. Flintstones probably more ubiquitous.
I think
more people would rather live in the future than live like cavemen.
You're crazy.
Yeah, but it's not about what they'd rather do. It's just about what they remember at the time.
Well, it might be about what they'd rather do because...
Oh. Damn it.
Flintstones was
Josh, you're always right.
Number three was the Waltons.
Oh, ew.
From like 1,000 years ago. Number six was the Nelsons. What is that from?
The Mandelas.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Nelson Mandelas.
Mandela family.
Oh, we suck. We can still win though. Here we go. Name something even little girls plan about their wedding. Boom. Dress. Sorted. Five answers. We can name five things about weddings. I got it. Dress. Probably husband, maybe, is number one. Dress, number one. Never had a doubt in my mind. All right, Josh. Name something even little girls plan about their marriages. What's your answer?
The wedding song.
Wedding song.
That could work.
It's an X.
Oh.
It's an X.
How could you plan your wedding song if you're like six? And Who Let the Dogs Out hasn't even come out yet. It's just foolish. Nick, name something even little girls plan about their wedding.
How about their bridesmaids?
Bridesmaids. Let's hope it's there. That's a second X.
Okay.
I'm not having a good time right now. That's okay. We can still make this work. I'm going to say the husband.
The groom. Oh, yeah, why didn't we say that already?
I should have said groom, because a husband was our third ex.
Damn.
What else is on there?
It's like we can't even relate to little girls.
It's probably a good thing.
That's a really bad way to phrase that.
Flowers? Oh, my God, they got it wrong. We're back in the game.
We're back in.
He typed old, new, borrowed, blue.
Little girls like cakes, right? Ring, cake?
Okay. Wow, okay, 71 was number one answer, the gown, 71. After that, four. The flowers, the location, the honeymoon, not really, and the cake. Okay.
Saying honeymoon is weird. Just gonna say
it
that.
Is. We're in sudden death. This is our wheelhouse right here. This is where we can do it. Josh.
Well, the honeymoon's where you do it, too.
Name something with a beginning, a middle, and an end.
A movie.
All right. Okay.
You're not wrong.
I think story might be it, though.
Yeah.
But is
they're all the same. Movie is a story.
Yeah, it's a visual story.
Oh, movie was an X.
A visual novella.
Movie was an X? Are you shitting
well,
my
Well, it's sudden death. It's got to be the number one answer.
It's the only answer.
Oh. You didn't tell me that.
Okay, well, you should always go for the number one answer.
I don't.
Oh.
Anyway, he said class, so luckily we're still in this anyway. All right, Nick.
Yes?
Let's do this. Name an animal whose breath could almost knock you out. We surveyed 100 people. Like,
who has bad breath?
Yeah.
A bear? What do you think? You think a bear has bad breath? Elephant breath?
Dog?
Skunk breath. Skunks have bad breath.
Dog.
Oh, yeah.
Just because it's the Family Feud.
I went to... too exotic.
Okay, dog is number one. We won. It was a fucking minefield. Gotta keep a steady hand on the rudder. Hey, I'm thinking of a number between 1 and 10. Nick, 69. What is it?
69. 6.
Okay, Josh,
6.
What is it?
6.9.
What is it actually?
Rounds to 7.
What is it actually? We got some time. We got a time limit thing going on here.
6.9.
Okay, well, Nick's closer then. So, Nick, if you could go away for a second, you can pay the second part of fast money. All right. Emperor Z just subscribed. Up 10 to the side. Welcome to the Lion Pride. Here we go.
What was it?
It was 4. It wasn't 6.9. Name something you get rid of when it doesn't work properly. Your house staff. No.
Your wife. Your second wife. Castle.
Car is not a good one. Oh, fuck. Pass. Tell me something people from small towns complain there's too much of when they visit a big city. People. Name an animal that doesn't have a leg to stand on. Snake. They have knees, though. Name something you have to give up to live the simple life. Money.
People.
Really? What does that mean, live the simple? You have to give up,
You get...
Ugh. Ugh. I don't know.
Electricity?
Really? I'm gonna say money. Fucking, I don't know. Yes. Name something people can't stop worrying about, even on vacation. Money. Name something you get rid of when it doesn't work. Money.
Money.
Name something you get rid of when it doesn't work.
It doesn't...
What about television?
Your microwave. Your microwave.
I'm gonna say television.
Yeah, it's a good one.
You don't get your microwave repaired? You gotta live the...
No, just get another one. They're like 20 bucks, dude. Man.
Throw your TV.
Are you scared?
Throw your TV out. Keep your microwave. Get your priorities straight.
I don't know.
All right, television was number one answer, by the way. People was not. Snake was. This is a tough, fast money round here, I think.
Money.
Wait, something you have to give up to live the simple life? Money was number one.
Oh, good.
Doesn't really make any sense, but sure.
I think
and money was the number one answer for the other one.
Really?
Yeah. Two middle
so you got
fingers,
three number one answers.
Straight up in the air. Four, I think. Nick!
Hey.
Hello.
Hey.
I kind of zoned out a little bit, but I heard money and snake a few times.
Name something you get rid of when it doesn't work properly.
The help. The hired help.
I was going to say that, but then I stopped because it's bad.
Is that your way of telling me not to say that?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
No, do it.
Appliances.
You both thought of it.
I don't think it's on there. Appliances. Tell me something people from small towns complain about when they go to the big city.
The noise.
Nice. By the way, you need 20 points.
Oh, we got this.
Name an animal that doesn't have a leg to stand on.
Animal with no legs. First thing I think of is fucking flamingo.
Yeah, I thought of that too.
That's not right. No legs on an animal. That's when you said snake. Okay, yeah. So fish.
Good answer.
No legs. No legs at all.
Wow, that's good.
Name something you have to give up to live the simple life.
Give up to live the simple life. So, like, you move out to the country and you don't have a nice house anymore, so you give up your house.
All right. Name something people can't stop worrying about, even on vacation.
Oh, this is where you said money. Now it's all coming together. Vacation, keep worrying about work.
Yeah.
Always worrying about
good
work.
Answer. I think we got this. I think we got this.
I hope so.
Appliances was zero.
Fine. So be it.
Well, Josh said microwave. Look at that guy.
It's an appliance, motherfucker.
Yeah, the appliances got zero. All right, noise got 15.
Yeah, microwave would have got 69.
Fish got 29. So
we made it.
We got it.
We made it. House got zero. And work got 16. We did it with bells on. Everyone made fun of me, Nick. I said money like 3 times in a row, and they were all right answers, like number one answers.
Yeah, because it's Lion's Law. You got this shit figured out.
Exactly, Lion's Law. Well, that's going to do it for Family Feud 2010 edition. Thanks for joining us so far. We still got another 2 hours of NLSS awaiting for you, complete with free game giveaways, but starting with Cook Serve Delicious when we come back from our 3-minute ad break. Thanks for joining us so far. Remember to follow the stream to be notified of when we go live in the future. We'll be back with some Cook Serve Delicious in 3 minutes.
Yay, time to put Nicolas Cage on Twitter.
Yeah.
I put my Hulk on Twitter in case you guys want to see that.
Did you draw Hulk
Hogan? Absolutely.
No, I drew
the Hulk.
Oh, Lou Ferrigno. Right. Lou Ferrigno. All right. Well, I'll check that out.
Let's do this.
Let me look at this. You never tweet me in it, do you?
Yes, I do. I tweet you every damn time in it.
I don't want you to tweet me in it. It makes it harder to find. Oh, my God. What is your... Like your Hulk is like a swamp creature. He's just like, it's a living. It looks like he just told like a really offensive joke on stage, and he's being booed, and he's like, what's your problem?
There's I tweeted you the picture that I use as a reference.
Okay. Oh, I think I know the picture.
Okay.
It's not my first time, you know. Look, I just went to Nick's Twitter and I saw the Steve Harwell picture again. All right, I'll be back in a second.
My Twitter's broken. It won't tweet my Nick Cage picture. Maybe it's too awesome for the internet.
Mm.
I'm gonna cancel right
back,
the
Nick.
Tweet.
Hold down the port.
I will. Hey, Fort. Anybody that's here that hears my words, not safe for wolf job. We're talking about wolf jobs right now in my chat and what those are. I assume they have something to do with like wolf therapy, where if you find yourself in a position where you're like in a like about to go on a scared straight show or something, maybe you could be put in front of wolf therapy, and then the wolves can kind of like coax you out of that rough point in your life and maybe back into more of a normal situation. I don't know. That's like a good wolf job that I would think that a wolf could really hold down if their family maybe needed, you know, maybe they have some wolf cubs and they're trying to feed them. Maybe they need some like free steaks or something. And the only way they can get the steaks is to pay for them with the wolf job money. What do you think? All right.
I think yes.
Yeah, so Josh agrees. He's in it for the wolf job.
The wolf job? Is that like a hand job?
No, not at all. No, it's like a job that a wolf holds down to feed its cubs. Or
Excuse
pups
me?
Or whatever. What do wolves have? Do they have cubs or pups?
They have pups.
I don't know.
Bears have pups.
I should look this up. Oh, yeah, they do have that. Steves have jobs.
Not wrong.
Nick is not high on smack, Grave Cactus. Just talking about wolf jobs, it's a normal thing.
Wolf
jobs. My Twitter's so broken. It's not posting this picture.
Wolf jobs.
Yeah, what's wrong with wolf jobs? Nobody believes in them.
What is a wolf job?
It's when they need to feed their family and they go and they do like wolf therapy so they can feed their cubs or pups or whatever they have.
Excuse me?
A wolf job is literally a wolf giving a guy a hand job. Stop that. Girl in the stone mask. It's not that simple.
I gave myself the hiccups.
I thought you were gonna say you gave yourself a wolf job.
It's offensive. I get a real wolf to give me my wolf jobs.
You really wolfed that down.
Oh, look who it is.
I've been here the whole time, motherfucker.
You guys are all eating?
I'm doing...
I had a candy bar.
I'm doing the sandwich thing.
How many halves do you have left?
I have one half left after this.
Okay. You should set up a couple more.
You know what's crazy is, like, when you cut a sandwich in half, I'm so glad we're back from ads so this conversation can be part of the NLSS. When you cut a sandwich in half, you have two choices, right? You can cut it in half, if you're just looking at, like, standard bread.
Yeah.
You can cut it in half either diagonally, or you can cut it in half, like, down the middle.
Yeah.
When you cut it in half diagonally, don't they seem way bigger?
Some people say that about manscaping.
What does that mean?
I don't know. Like, if you trim the hedges, the tree looks bigger.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if it applies to sandwiches, though. Also, there's another option. That's if you're doing a BLT-style display,
yeah.
You could do it into quarters.
Well, yes,
which is classy as hell. You put the, you know, toothpicks in it and everything.
But how do you want to do the quarters? Do you want them to be triangles, or do you want them to be squares?
Oh, God, you're right. Well, I didn't even think about
that.
Definitely
triangles.
Yeah, every time.
You cut diagonally, man.
I just proved your point by accident.
Exactly. The other thing about diagonally is that they fit into the mouth better, because... Like,
yeah, it's a good one. Things fit into the mouth.
They're pointed, right?
Well, and the first bite, you get the most sandwich without crust.
I agree, yeah.
Which is critical. Okay, I'm trying the Nick Cage submit again. Please tweet. Please tweet.
It
keeps getting stuck. Oh, there it goes.
Oh, I see it. Oh, that's a good picture. That's like, what's his face? Is
Oh my God.
Profile picture.
Thanks.
That is, well, we all know what picture this is based on.
Yeah.
Do we?
It's what's his face's profile picture.
Nicolas Cage's.
What's his face? Jeff Gerstmann, maybe?
Alex.
Alex, yes.
Alex Navarro, yeah.
Navarro.
From Giant Bomb. Does it... Yeah. Bear with me on this one. This looks like a bald staff at, like, a lunchroom for a high school, and then... Like, somebody just ordered something, and then they showed him. They're like, Nicolas Cage, lunch lady, do you like my new backpack? And he's like, yes! So, it's so cute!
Oh, I'm so sorry that I laughed through that whole thing, because the Dracula fetus animation's gonna suffer.
His hair looks like a hairnet, you see? It really does. Keeps his brain in.
The voice, though, that was so Adam Sandler. The,
Well, I did watch Just Go With It.
All right.
In any case, you guys want to play Cooks Are Delicious?
Yeah. I have a save file, so yeah.
I think Josh and I have, like, the furthest ahead save file ever.
Oh, that's how it is.
We're on, like, day 94. I'm on day
I finally
94.
Catch up, and you motherfuckers get 20 more days
ahead.
Well,
what day are you on?
84.
I'm on day 94.
Oh, well, I'm on 94 as well. Well, this is good, because we're going to have a harder time, and then you'll be able to swing it and make it work.
We're all on 94.
No, Nick's on 84.
Oh, we're no, 10 days ahead of her.
Yo, yeah. Nobody's saying that crusts are bad, but the crust ratio, the way you handle... You don't eat the crust on your sandwich?
Uncrustables, man. They gotta go down.
You don't eat the crust on your sandwich?
No, I eat it. It's just I'm sad about it every time.
Really?
Oh, I love the crust. Bring on the crust. I'm a crusty okay, man.
I'll save all my crust for you, and then next year I'll drop them off.
Saving my crust for you, baby.
I'll bring them all to PAX. I'll fill up a backpack full.
Bring in my backpack of crusts. Anyway... There's a song in there somewhere. Let's create a menu of Cooks Are Delicious goodness, shall we? I'm going to start. Nick, do you have 6 items? Do you have 6 slots available on your active menu?
I got to remember how to do all this. So I go to View by Foods, see what's bought. Okay, it looks like everything's bought already.
I'm going to start with fish. It's satisfying.
Is that your daily special?
No, yes.
Yeah, I have 6 slots.
I'm putting beer in as my daily special.
All right. So I took fish... I took fish, Josh took beer. What are you going to have, Nick?
Egg McMuffins, man.
Oh, breakfast sandwiches. I'm glad I didn't pick that. I almost picked it for myself. I'm going to throw on... you know what? I'm going to be a brave dude and throw on soda.
I'm doing a breakfast restaurant.
Soda.
We're supposed to all have the same thing.
Why?
This looks...
I'm going to do pancakes and lobster.
You.
I think this is a chicken, or maybe it's a steak. No, it's a chicken. It's above the steak.
It's under the ice cream.
What's the advantage of taking lots of items? Why wouldn't you just take like 4?
You get like better buzz, and you can make more money.
Get more buzz.
Take 4.
You're only gonna take, Nick. You got to take 6 items.
No, Nick.
I'm taking four items I've never taken before, though.
We got to take the same items.
Oh. Nick, this is how it works.
Okay.
Reconstruct your menu: fish, beer, breakfast sandwiches. Soda, chicken, which kind of looks like a shoe sole with chocolate syrup crisscrossed over top. And then you get to choose the number 6 slot.
Okay, fish, beer, breakfast sandwiches, soda.
Then chicken, which is just below ice cream.
I made an amendment to mine.
Okay.
OTI Brack the man says I should make fish my daily special and to trust him. So I'm going to do that.
Yeah, it's a good idea, man.
Wait, what?
I put fish Wolf in
Job
the daily
just
special
subscribed
slot.
To me. Thank you, Wolf Job. I guess all that talk made you excited. I appreciate it.
All right, Nick.
So I'm going to pick... What's that annoying one? Lasagna?
Lasagna's pretty bad, yeah.
Would you rather have lasagna or, like, mixed salad?
Salad's pretty nasty, too.
Okay, what's in the bottom right corner? The staple one that's like a tomato soup. And it looks like an orange soup?
Yeah.
How's that? I've never done
it. That's also extremely bad.
Damn.
Nick, just follow your heart, man.
Yeah, just pick whatever you want.
What about fritters?
Where are those?
Second page, right corner next to the breakfast sandwiches. I don't know what those are.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, like the sopapillas.
Sopapillas.
Yeah, I'm doing that.
Sure.
It's a fried thing.
Sopapillas are on there.
Cool.
Are we ready?
I'm ready.
Let's begin. 3, 2, 1, go. By the way, you can check out everybody's perspectives on this. MultiTwitch.tv/allofournames, aka MultiTwitch.tv/NorthernLion/JaceMinOTI/RockleySmile. Oh, I forgot about breakfast sandwiches. They come in.
Oh, how do
in,
I play this game?
They come in and they say...
Purple Fish Bowl, thank you.
I forget how to play this game.
Down, right, seasoning lemon.
Oh, God.
Oh, no lemon.
Small tea.
It's going to take a minute to get back in the groove here,
yeah,
guys.
Yeah, it'll take a little while, but just the sausage, please.
Upsize.
Yeah, by the way, drink. Throwing soda on there was a dick move, but I always feel like...
Ice.
Even though this is a video game, I feel kind of bad when the restaurant only has beer and wine, because kids come in and they're like, I'm thirsty, and you're like, well, I'm sorry. We have old beer.
I love beer. Beer's the most fun one to do of all.
What kind of scums do you have coming into your restaurants? I've exclusively made breakfast sandwiches and chicken so far.
No, I've had a lot.
I have a trendy... I've
screwed up every order.
A culinary appropriate kind of crowd coming into my restaurant.
I got fish people and
fish
chicken people.
Fish, you gotta get that checked out.
Beer people. I flushed a toilet once.
Ah, I did that as well.
Now it's rush hour.
Oh, don't give me rush hour, man. I can't take this already.
I also have rush hour.
Jumbo.
On Blu-ray. Jumbo
water with ice. Ice cube.
Oh, the fish, man, is so satisfying.
I can't serve this.
You gotta cook it first, man.
Oh, I didn't pour it. All right, I'm dumb. Okay.
A jumbo. Oh my god, I forgot how to
do it. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, season cook. 5.
A total
jumbo.
Oh my god.
This is a nightmare.
Why did I pick soda? That was dumb. Also, fucking, how much trash could I possibly make? Small grape with ice. Boom. Medium.
Just the sausage, please.
I know, right? Who doesn't like just the sausage, please?
Just the sausage, please. Egg B. 3.
Oh. What the heck?
Can I flush the toilet?
They fucked up my progress by ending the rush hour. It's going pretty well, though.
I'm so not that good. Oh.
Nobody wants lemon on their fish.
I had a frame rate.
They don't like the lemon.
I had a frame rate issue and it fucked up my streak. But then I fucked it up anyway by sending a dude like a half-made breakfast sandwich. Doesn't like a half-made breakfast sandwich sounds like a great end to a simile? Like she got eaten up for $2.99 like a half-eaten breakfast sandwich.
Now that you say it like that, yeah.
I picked her up at McDonald's at 11 a.m. like a half-eaten breakfast sandwich. Or 11:02 would be better.
Bacon. I want this sandwich, man. This egg sausage sandwich.
I love...
So good.
The sausage sandwiches.
What? Tenderize. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The McGriddle, man.
Yeah.
I've actually made decisions about my
McGriddle,
day.
But no, the ultimate breakfast... This is my first breakfast sandwich I'm making, actually.
Weird. Sorry to hear that.
Hey, can you deep fry those potatoes? But no salt, please. I'm trying to watch my cholesterol.
You don't really like. Why are you cooking like the sausage and bacon? Why are you cooking? I don't know the warmth, the bread and stuff at the same time as the sausage and the bacon.
I was kind of picturing you put it all in like a sous vide bag or something like that, and then you just toss it into the sous videry, and then it comes out.
I don't know what a sous videry is.
It's the bag of water. It's hot.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know what
it's
I just said.
It's a hot bag of water, basically.
Meg Resta doesn't. Like the taste of me.
Excuse me?
I won't sue you.
I have one new item in my inventory. I wonder if it's this related.
Oh, yeah, dude.
I just
got
that too.
You just got that too?
No salt.
Oh, it's a rush hour again.
I burned the fucking.
Keep burning
me
things, man.
God damn it.
Everyone wants fish for rush hour.
With salt.
It's actually not that bad. Fish is pretty great.
Dude, fish is the most satisfying.
I hate soda. Small tea.
Yeah, like soda was a bad decision on my part. I apologize.
Flavor.
What you should do is just get like a self-serve.
Yeah, why can't we do that? That's such a good decision. Egg, bacon.
Whenever I see people like get bent out of shape about like, hey, no free refills, I'm like, this is like 0 cent cost to you. Yeah, well, I don't know anything about business.
Everybody's so angry at me. I'm trying my best, guys.
It's okay.
Give me a break here.
You got thrown into the thick of things. It's like Ratatouille.
Bacon. Yeah, but he was a rat. I'm at least a human.
Yeah, but I mean, you're like the human from Ratatouille.
Oh. Yeah, poor guy.
But he had the rat for a little while, anyway.
But he, like, went to cooking school, didn't he?
No, that's the thing, man.
Oh.
Have you not seen Ratatouille?
I maybe not, actually.
I actually watched it on the flight back from my ancestral home.
Cook.
I think I made someone mad.
Everybody else on the flight was watching We're the Millers, and I was like, I ain't gonna do that.
That's dumb. Yeah. Don't do that.
And they were laughing.
Who's the Millers?
I don't know. It's got Jason.
Dude, I'm so bad at like talking and trying to play this game at the same time. I can't do it. I have no idea how you guys can do that.
I'm barely able to. I don't know. I'm
barely
anyway.
I'm fairly tappy.
No, Bear is. He streams after the show.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you're right about that. No, the ass is today.
No, that's only tomorrow.
And the Michael A. L. Fox show's today.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, indeed.
I'll pack a patrol and Foxman in live.
Yeah.
Sausage. Just the sausage, please.
Just are
the
they sausage, both partner now?
Yes. Michael A. L. Fox also has the subscriber button.
Oh,
pretty
nice,
cool,
nice.
Right?
Roger's got cool. His little heads that he's putting next to everybody that subscribes.
Twitch is
his icon.
Working him through, man.
Yeah.
Good on them. Hey, it's closing time.
Jumbo diet.
Oh, thank goodness I can breathe again.
Ice. Play with blast. There we go. Closing time. Day complete.
Let's go over stats.
Yep.
Customer served. 57.
57.
52. Oh, wow. Gosh. You guys are a lot better than me. I'm scum.
Okay. Perfect. 53.
32.
47.
Average 3.
9.
4.
Good, man. Couldn't be 60 more. Bad. 1.
1.
16.
Ooh, no, Nick.
Yeah.
Tips earned. Chores
no, chores completed.
Oh, 11 out of 11.
Me too.
7 out of 8.
Tips earned. $5.
34.
How did I only get $5?
I don't know.
Okay, highest combo and income of the day. 18,685.
Highest combo is 25, and I earn 706.
Whoa, you win.
Wow, highest combo is 6 and 365.
That's a dollar per day, man.
A dollar a day keeps the doctor away.
Not
one day.
Well, you can't go to the doctor if you only make a dollar a day, I think.
How many crumbs really did you guys make?
I was clicked away from the screen, Josh.
None.
I made 0 crumbs, too.
Well, no crumbs at all.
Very I'm nice. Going to go ahead and assume that Ryan made 69 crumbs.
Well, what's the matter? I had just to get somebody else to clean it up.
Make up for all of us.
It's not like I do everything in this restaurant. Oh wait. Okay, why don't we do the menu again?
Menu.
I'll start. I'm gonna put burgers on the menu.
Thank you.
That's gonna be a daily special.
Burgers. I'll make that my daily
burgers.
Special too. I'm gonna keep beer on as a staple.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I like how it is a staple. True enough.
Beer and burgers are great together.
It's true.
Yeah.
That means my turn. Let's put ice cream in there.
Okay,
ice
that's
cream.
Good. Get a dessert thing on there. I'm gonna throw lobster in. I'm gonna
lobster.
I'm gonna make this kind of like it's a gastropub.
Okay,
You know, like a fancy one.
Yeah. So obviously, I'm gonna go with sushi.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we already have the lobster, so it's just easy.
Ooh, I've never made sushi in this. This is gonna be scary.
Sushi's fun.
It's really easy. Yeah.
I like seeing just the sausage, please, so I'm going to put the breakfast sandwiches back in.
I did win with Brack the Man's advice. That's what I'll say. That.
All right. We're ready to start a new day then.
Wait, what Nick picked?
He picked breakfast sandwich again.
Breakfast sandwiches
again. Hear them say just the sausage.
Okay.
All right. Here we go. Three,
ready?
Two, one, go. Got to get above a 22 combo, otherwise I can't get upgraded to the next level. Of restaurant.
Mm. Beer. Thank you for putting
it's like
beer.
Five times in a row that you gotta do it.
No, three five troubles. Times in total.
That person just wanted a lettuce, tomato, and pickled burger.
Like, with no meat.
No meat.
it's a different kind of veggie burger.
It was called the veggie.
I mean, you should really just like go to a maybe Subway or something, because these are just hamburger buns I got at the store.
Two pecans.
They don't know that.
Cherry.
Two meat patties. Good call.
Oh, I messed that guy's thing up? That's stupid.
Double.
Who's coming in for this 10 a.m.? I don't know what's weirder. 10 a.m. lobster or 10 a.m. ice cream?
10 a.m. beer.
I had both.
Dude, nothing wrong with 10 a.m. beer except in the eyes of most, you know, legal legislations and jurisdictions.
Cheese and Swiss cheese. You're mixing cheeses too? Wow.
I fucked up the dude's sushi. all
it's
toppings.
Always like the first letter. Meat, bacon, pickles. To flush sanitize.
Dude, yeah. Ice cream's kind of tricky.
Meat, tomatoes,
bacon,
pickles,
lettuce, tomatoes, cheese. Enter. The one BLT one. NC.
Ooh, lobster, first time. L.
Okay.
Three.
Oh, I just hit L.
Three meat patties. This guy's going all out.
Meat, lettuce.
Oh, I like burger. Burger's good.
Meat, I have a lot bacon, of burgers cheese. Coming up. Two cups of butter. Two, you got it, man. Three.
Just meat, the sausage. Sausage.
Easy. Cheese.
Okay.
Five. Egg. Meat, lettuce. Oh, God.
Four. Uh-huh. Boiled chilled lobster. Enter. This is insane already.
No.
It's getting out of control pretty fast.
Too easy.
You're too good at this game.
Let's see.
This guy just ordered the My Little Pony Burger.
Yes.
Meat, lettuce, pickles.
Oh, God.
Bacon, lettuce, tomatoes, cheese.
Three R.
Two. I'm coming up.
Oh, man. This is good stuff. How's your guys' days going?
You know.
Do you remember the hardest math question you answered in high school?
No.
Tell me your life story.
Bacon, lettuce, tomatoes, cheese.
M. Two.
Ooh, that's good stuff right there. Okay.
Seven.
Rush I remember when Josh was like, how come you guys can talk during this? And I was like, I don't know, I can barely do it. Now I can't.
I can't.
Oh.
I can't do anything. I'm useless.
I'm feeling great about this.
Really?
Yeah. Sincerely.
Oh my God, my rush hour was super bad. Like, I don't even know what I was doing half the time.
All the toppings? You got it, mister. Nobody else to distract me. Oh, that's good stuff. If I just get this burger right, then that's 22. Okay.
Trash is piling up. Get it out of here, man.
One day, like, we're going to play this enough on the stream that we're actually just going to beat it.
All at the same time?
Give me two vanilla scoops with nuts.
Please. Set traps.
Why
set
do
lock.
Beer is
such
so
things?
Refreshing. It's just like you know exactly what you're going to get.
Yeah. Beer. Egg. You can only have
sausage.
One, right?
Yeah.
Two chocolate scoops and nuts.
Ooh, a little resting time here.
What's next? Just the sausage, please?
Just a paper, please.
It was just the sausage, please.
Really?
A demure, middle-aged librarian-looking lady. Just the sausage,
I think
please.
I've served her. She's come to my place,
this
too.
Lady wants no sauces.
Yeah. I like how they call butter a sauce. Like, I don't know about that.
It's butter sauce. It comes in a little cup.
I don't think it's butter sauce. I think it's just melted butter.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we need
unless
to believe that
it
it's something
sauce,
more
put,
than
like,
just
some
butter.
Cream in there.
Something
yeah,
more.
We don't want to just believe we're just eating straight butter, though.
Yeah.
So we gotta say it's sauce.
Butter and heavy cream.
Creme.
It won't clog anyone's arteries. Don't worry about it.
Oh, this is going pretty well so far.
Next rush hour is gonna come soon.
Yeah,
I'm
very excited about
it. Here it is. No.
What's your problem? Dude, rush hour is the most fun.
Maybe if you're Jackie Chan.
Quick, name five things that aren't Jackie Chan.
Can't do
meat
it.
Meat patties. Eddie, bro.
Anyway.
I don't know how you just go from not serving any sushi to all of a sudden one day you are serving sushi. You don't just do that.
Try out a new leaf, man.
Lettuce, onions, tomatoes. There's no meat on this.
Yeah, that's weird. I don't understand the appeal of like hamburger buns without meat on them, or not without meat, but like with the shittiest toppings. At least you gotta have good bread if you're gonna have a vegetarian sandwich. I've eaten vegetarian sandwiches on many an occasion. I like them a lot, but it's all about bread, man.
It's all about the bread, man.
Even more so than with a regular sandwich, and you know, with a regular sandwich, we've already talked about how bread integrity is a very integral part. The
this game
process.
Really feels stressful, like a real job sometimes.
You guys are nuts. This is just a relaxing, like Sunday trip to.
Oh no!
Seven sausage.
Swiss
bacon.
Cheese is S.
Yeah.
Meat, lettuce, bacon, cheese, tomato.
Lettuce, bacon,
five.
Cheese, tomatoes, pickles.
Flush the toilet, dude.
E-R.
Oh, I am feeling fucking groovy here.
Shit.
This is good.
Got it. Trash is piling up. It's rush hour. No one has time for that.
Just the sausage, please. You got it, Joker. What is this? Oh, someone wants me to take a picture with them because my food's that good?
Yeah, me too.
Nice.
All right.
I took a picture of it as well. It's like we're on the same day or something.
Nuts and strawberry sauce. These ice cream mortars are real complicated sometimes.
People don't give enough credit to people who work at a creamery. There's a lot going on there. It's not true, just scooping. Yeah. There's a craft to it.
You're not wrong. You got to put it on the cold stone, and then if they tip you a dollar, you sing for it and, you know, try to forget the fact that we're all going to die someday.
Lady, you're ordering job, lobster. Actually. It's closing time. I have to wait for this lady. She came in. I had to boil the lobster right before closing.
Yeah.
Here, have your one cup of butter and get the fuck out of here.
Are you done?
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay.
I'm done.
Customer served. 59.
52.
45.
Orders of the day. Perfect. 58.
36.
Average, 0.
8.
3.
Bad, 1.
7. 3.
Hey, Andrea Bocelli's eyes just subscribed. That's pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
He's got chores completed. Eyes, though?
He's got some funny
10 out of 11, I got chores.
14 out of 14.
13 out of 13.
How about tips?
Tips earned? 60.
24.
$60?
$60.
I made $12 in tips.
I think I had 12 right before that lobster lady. I think she literally tipped me like.
Because she knew she was keeping you open. She wanted to give you a nice little, you know, goodbye.
How do you get so many tips?
I made one crumb.
I made 7.
No crumbs here.
What about highest combo?
12.
6.
55.
God damn it.
Are you fucking my asshole?
I'm serious, but I still think Josh might have more money. Wait, how much did you earn today, Josh?
635.
635?
Yeah.
I made 591.
Man, what's it like to be shitty?
You guys, it's literally $48 in tips that makes, like, the bulk of that difference.
Yeah.
Fucking so like charismatic this. Bartender types, I think he's, like, hitting on everybody that comes in.
It must be. It must be. But the saving grace is one more beautiful 22 perfect combo on 5 separate days, and I go up to a 4-star restaurant.
That's impressive.
I think I'll charge people more for that. Maybe. Yeah. Unlock some new menu items.
your chat says bullshit. Suck it, chat.
It is bullshit. Your chat. I don't understand how you... doesn't make any sense. Fafa Moffer, just subscribe. That's a great name.
I need 4-2 more 20 times perfect combos.
Maybe you just do them all in one day and stop complaining.
I can just get my only thing. I'm just going to have beer for the special and fish. That's it.
So you're going to take else. Those are going to be your two items, beer and fish.
Yeah.
Beer and fish.
All right, Nick, okay. What are your two choices going to be?
My two choices are going to be, is that Bananas Foster down there? I didn't even see that. Oh, yeah, I'll put that shit on there.
He
Bananas
is the Foster one.
And pancakes.
Okay, Bananas Foster and pancakes.
Bananas Foster's the one
that looks like peaches.
Yeah, okay.
All right. Well.
And what are you taking?
Well, this looks like it's going to be a pretty simple day. I'm going to take fried chicken.
Okay.
And.
Oh, that's good.
Take something easier. Fried chicken and wine.
Wine is easy for you?
Fried chicken and wine.
Fried chicken and wine.
Wine sucks.
Here we go.
Oh, we're in. I'm ready.
Oh, okay. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay. Just got across 22.
I wish you luck.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Bottle of serpent beer, please.
Fish is the best.
Dude, fish, yeah, it just feels right.
Feels good.
Like when you hit the things on the D-pad.
Keyboard?
Yeah. One delicious dish, please.
Beer feels just as right as fish does, though.
It does.
Yeah, beer and fish. That's why I only want to take them.
How do you cook pancakes?
Oh, properly? There's a robber here. he was ninja.
Oh God, shoot him!
Get his face right.
He was a ninja.
Lin Mac, what the fuck is Bananas Foster?
Press enter for justice. I just tapped all this kind of. Oh, I need to select a nose. Yeah, there you go. Oh God, do I?
It's like bananas and caramelized alcohol, right? With sugar.
I've never had so Bananas Foster, escaped. Nick. I always just call it peach cobbler.
Bananas and Foster's beer.
Bananas wine and Foster's.
I got 3 people that want wine. I give 2 dicks what the hell it is.
Quit whining.
Ooh.
Get out.
Boom. Okay. I think we're going to start having some problems in rush hour when people start ordering Bananas Foster's. all the time. Bananas Foster. Fosters.
Bam.
All right. Oh, Rush
Hour. Banana cakes are going to... Banana cakes. Pancakes are going to be the wild card, aren't they?
Make banana pancakes. It's Jack Johnson. Tim the Toolman, Taylor, Jonathan, Jack Johnson. You know.
You lost me on that
one. You know the rules.
Cake, strawberry, syrup, butter.
Dude.
No, not beer. I meant to hit pancake. Now the...
This is wine. Oh, no. I gave the guy a bottle of cheap wine because I started to take the cork out, and you can't go back from that.
Go back from that.
You can't go back. Once you start uncorking, you're fucked.
That's bullshit. Beard. It doesn't make any sense. It's cheap wine. They're paying like $6 a bottle. Why would they care if the cork's so slightly less in the bottle?
Oh, you gotta mash the freaking... Oh, man, that's annoying.
Yeah,
this guy wanted the cheap wine. Ugh.
I'm gonna do everything but the wine then and just let those go.
Dude, the wine is where you make your tips on, I'm pretty sure.
Fine.
Which is important, apparently, because even if you get everything right, Josh can still beat you. This is just like how you fucking beat me in Typing of the Dead by just hitting tab over and over while typing.
Kazu, that was bullshit. Haven't you learned the rule is that Josh just wins, though, all the time?
That's true, actually.
Yeah. I'm not winning this one. I'm not doing wine. I hate wine. I
actually fucked up my day pretty bad.
Yeah, my day is just the most...
Ruined. Two-fingered wine makes a big difference. Try that out. What?
What do you mean? Like, you like put two fingers on the up button and then just like...
Yeah, alternate? You just alternate.
But then I gotta move my hand off of the number keys.
Works for me.
But then I gotta put him back.
Yeah, but it gets way more wine out.
Nah, it's okay.
Amy wine out.
Amy Law.
Yeah.
I don't know what else to do with the bananas.
You hit BS and then you wait for them to smoke and then you put the bananas.
BS. I haven't gotten any bananas yet.
You haven't made any bananas yet.
No, just fish and wine and pancakes mostly.
Oh. I just want to make fish all day.
Can we just put fish on your menu? Fish and beer.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Dude, it'd
be the easiest day ever.
Two-fingered wine is not easier.
Two-fingered wine is easier for me.
A lot of Deckard wine.
I'm getting tips for it, too.
I'll give you
ladies
a tip.
Ladies love my two-fingered wine.
Wine.
That's the sound it makes.
I got really confused, because, like, maple syrup is M. That makes sense, but then
Andrea Bocelli's eyes, up, down, all around. Welcome to J. Smithtown, and enjoy your sound. You can't.
Enjoy your sound and your trip.
Here we go. Don't fuck anything else up, and I can still get to that 4-star level.
Go two-fingered wine. Yes.
Dude, how is two-fingered wine better for you?
It's so good.
If they could just give me, like, everybody, they come in at the same rate, but they all order fish. That would be good. That would be awesome.
Can you hear my two-fingered wine when I go at it?
Yeah, that actually is pretty fast. I'm impressed.
Delicious dish, please. Be sure to wait for the pan to get hot with butter. Okay, go.
3 BS and then A.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you wait.
After it gets smoky.
Yeah.
BS and then A. Got it.
After it gets smoky.
PPP. Oh shit, everything's here all of a sudden.
Oh, this feels
good. Oh, but.
Bottle of elk wine, please. Yes, you may have the elk wine.
PPPSB, go. Oh no, the wine, get the wine.
Two hands don't work.
Two hand wine, go.
Dude, I'm telling you, Josh is right. Two hands don't work.
No.
Oh.
Cheapest wine, go.
That makes me mad because I'm doing wine.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, everybody.
Wait for A. Go.
Yep, it's the wine, man. I fucked up my shit.
Now I'm messing up beer and everything.
Oh, well, there's just no excuse for that.
I know there isn't.
All right, so wine's never showing up again.
Can I just put on 3 pancakes for every order? Worry about it later?
Yeah, seriously, why do these people have such a say in what they get?
Just throw them out. No, I mean, they can still get one pancake if they ordered one. I'll just put on 3 because it means they don't have to think about it.
Right.
Let's flush your profits away, man.
No, I don't care.
No, we've done the research.
We have.
We've done the research.
Josh says we've done the research, we have.
I'm not going to be able to cross the 22 threshold. Touchdown. They're in Shopwa.
Mm-hmm. Oh no, I've served too early. Damn. SB.
I got more in tips today, though. Wine's basically bullshit. I want to get like a brand new keyboard. Just for wine.
Just for wine.
Yeah, and then you just hold the button down.
You should tell the dev about that. Maybe you get some kind of a talk.
He can get like a branded deal with Razer or something like that.
All right.
Hey, Josh, how much money did you make today, fucker?
349.
I made 1,008.
Holy fuck.
That's insane.
How many tips?
Were you just robbing people when they came
into
your place?
I don't know how I made so much money.
I earned $29 in tips.
I earned $49.